In Queensland, enforcer Ben Teo broke from his state of origin camp today, turning up at a Ferny Grove police station to tell his side of the story after being accused of giving a young woman a black eye. Max Futcher is with the Maroons on the Sunshine Coast and joins us now live. And Max, do we know what he told detectives?
No, Georgie, other than to assume, as you say, his side of the story. We do know Ben Teo left here early this morning and went with his lawyer to the Ferny Grove police station. He arrived there about 9 a.m. and left shortly before noon. He is here at training with the Maroons at Coolum this evening. A little bit earlier this afternoon, the Maroons held a press conference in which they offered up the players Greg Inglis and Corey Parker for interview, on the proviso that no one asked any questions about the Ben Teo affair or they would end the press conference. After 3 hours speaking with detectives, Ben Teo was driven from Ferny Grove Police Station back to the Queensland Origin camp on the Sunshine Coast. Teo went to the police a day after Katie Lewis was in the same building, accusing the Queensland footballer of punching her in the face and breaking her eye socket. After giving his side of the story, he was back at training with the squad this afternoon. Teammates deny it's caused any disruption.
I'll tell you what we can control, and that's what happens out here on the training paddock. We can't control anything else outside of that, so there's no use worrying about it.
Another player allegedly there on the night in question, Darius Boyd, was testing his injured ankle this morning, although prying eyes weren't welcome.
Can you knock that on the head, please, for filming?
Such is the siege-like environment at Camp Maroon this week. It is a touchy subject here, almost off-limits, but while the Queensland team closes ranks, their opposition can sense turmoil.
Their team at the moment looks like they're in a bit of disarray, but we're going to prepare for the best Queensland team.
Oh, mate, in the end, they can think what they want. We know what's going on here, and we know what's going on within our team and within our teammates, so in the end, they can think what they want. We just know what's going on here.
Yeah, rightly so. They can have an opinion, but, yeah, I'm not offended by it.
The NRL's Integrity Commission is yet to decide if Teo faces sanctions. Queensland Police say their investigation is ongoing and no charges have been laid. Ben Teo strongly denies any wrongdoing. The NRL released a statement this afternoon saying its Integrity Commission has suspended its investigation while the Queensland Police investigation is ongoing. It's very likely this will still be hanging over the game when the Origin Opener gets underway next Wednesday, Georgie.
Thanks for the update. Max Futcher there on the Sunshine Coast.